done for this week. So, if y'all come up, it's okay, I promise. We won't bite you. You're gonna have tons of fun. It's okay. Thank you, Rayleigh. Y'all can sit right up here, or y'all can sit back behind it. It's up to y'all. Okay, now, we're gonna ask everybody to stand. Stacy's probably gonna tell you this later, but when you see us on stage, you're gonna stand up and we're gonna dance. Yes, I know. It's awkward, but it's gonna happen. And then Stacy's gonna come up, and when you see him come up, you can sit down. So, that's the rules for this morning. Now I stand up. Ready?
Good
job. Y'all can have a seat.
Here we go. Miss Claire, here we go.
Hi, everyone. My name is Robin, and this is Carissa.
That's Special Agent Carissa. I'm a special agent.
Not technically.
Yeah, I am.
Well, we better clarify. You're not a special agent yet, Carissa. But if you come to Agency D3 starting tomorrow, you can become a special agent for Agency D3.
Do I get a special badge like yours? Or a cool disguise?
Sure, why not?
Oh, look, I already have my cool gadget. You can talk. Hello.
Okay, so, Carissa, I think that you'll make a great special agent.
Shh, I'm on a mission.
But VBS hasn't even started yet.
Yes, but it will soon. So you'd better brief them about the secret code they will need to gain security entrance to VBS.
It's not a secret, Carissa, but just so you know, you can put it in your evidence logs, aka calendar. We have VBS starting this Monday from 9 to 12, and it'll go through Thursday. Registration starts at 8:30 if you have not signed up yet. You will just pull up in front of the church. I almost said school. I don't know why. You'll pull up in front of the school, church, and drop off your kids. And if they've already registered, you'll send them right in. If not, you can park and bring them in and register here in the front foyer.
But shh, keep it a secret.
Carissa, it's not a secret.
Now you know what we put up with our house. Good to see you this morning. This is our Vacation Bible School morning. We're going to give you a kind of a snapshot of the theme of each day this morning, and you'll hear all the music of Vacation Bible School this week. If you're a guest in our service, we're glad you're here this morning. And I'll ask you to fill out one of the cards you see in the hymnal rack and return that to us later. But let's stand now. You greet everyone around you as we begin our time of worship today. Welcome all of you who are joining us today on Channel 6. You're watching the services of First Baptist Church here in Muleshoe. And we're proud to be able to bring these to you. And we hope they're a blessing as you worship with us. God bless you and thanks for joining us.
I got my music, my money, my phone. I think I'm
up a little bit. We can't hear it really. Thank you.
Everybody say yes, yes. To be yes.
Gonna say yeah, 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 yes. To the BBS. Gonna say yeah, 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 yes. To the BBS. Y-E-S to V-B-S. Y-E-S to V-B-S.
Yes.
Yes to VBS.
Yes.
Yes to VBS.
Everybody say yes.
Yes.
Yes
to VBS. Yes. Yes to VBS.
Everybody say yes.
Yes.
Yes to VBS.
We're gonna say yes to VBS.
The rock and roll show probably.
Say yes to VBS.
I'll learn my ABCs.
We're gonna say yes to VBS.
But read the word of God.
Say yes to VBS.
But live and learn by Jesus. The blessing of studying God's word. Yes, to the blessing. Jesus is Lord.
Can say yeah, 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 yes.
To love of the BBS. Can say yeah, 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 yes. To love of the BBS.
Can say yes.
To love of the BBS.
Can say yeah, 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 yes.
To love of the BBS.
Let's pray together. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for the joy of this children's music that fills us with energy and puts smiles on our faces and reminds us of your love for us. Lord, we look forward to this week with the children of our community coming to sing, to do crafts, many to have a meal, but also to hear your word. Father, we ask that you bless everyone who will work in this week. Everyone from those who help us to unload the vehicles out front to registration to teaching to recreation to everything we do. May your hands be upon us and may we bless the children of this community in the gospel of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We're going to start tomorrow morning by trying to explain who Jesus is and how he is the Son of God. And we're going to start by the relationship between John the Baptist and Jesus. John the Baptist, you'll remember, is a wild desert man. His hair is out of control. His beard is long. He's wearing skins made of camel hair and eating grasshoppers. He is an unusual guy. But he goes throughout the land saying, make way for the Messiah. Prepare the way for the Messiah. Make the path straight, he says, for the Messiah. And he goes about telling people that their lives are full of sin and they need to repent. He tells them that they lie too much, that they cuss too much. He tells them that they're not always honest with one another. And he tells them that there are things in their lives that the Lord's unhappy with. And in the process of telling them the things in their lives that God is unhappy with and their need to repent, he takes them out into the wilderness, out to the Jordan River, and he's asking them, as a symbol of your repentance before God, be baptized in this water. It's to show that you're going to turn from your ways. Come and be baptized in this water. And people began to be baptized. And people were being baptized and other people were showing up to see what was going on. And he's pretty hard on people. One time there was a group of leaders from Jerusalem who came and they didn't repent. And he said to them, you're a bunch of snakes. But John the Baptist is doing this baptism of repentance and telling the people they need to turn from their wicked ways. When one day he's baptizing people and there appears in the line Jesus. And they get in a little bit of a discussion about it. John says, oh, I shouldn't baptize you. You should baptize me. And Jesus says, no, this is the way the Lord has it to be. You baptize me. And John the Baptist baptized Jesus in the Jordan River, and when he raised him up out of the water, it says the heavens opened and the Spirit came down and descended upon him like a dove. And the scripture says a voice boomed from heaven and said, "This is my son, hear him." John the Baptist prepared the people to meet God's son. Campbell, come up here. Am I going to embarrass you? You know what the plagues of Egypt are?
No.
There's 10 of them. 10 bad things that happened. And I'm going to talk about some of them, and you tell me which one you would like the least, okay?
Okay.
They turned the Nile River into blood. One time the land was covered in frogs. Frogs. All there were so many frogs, they were in people's beds. Okay? Another time, a hailstorm came and ruined all the crops. Worse than what we had last night. Fire fell from heaven. One time, lice were so bad that people were just covered in lice. One time, they had boils on their skin. Another time, the plagues came and the grasshoppers ate all the crops in the land. It's so bad that even the animals were disturbed. Now, which one of those do you think is the worst?
Fire.
Fire falling from heaven. Okay. Have you ever seen that?
Yes.
No. But that's your worst thing. Okay. You know, mine, I think, is the boils. Sores all over their bodies. I think that's the worst. But I think the lice might be the most irritating thing of the bunch. Can you imagine? You're scratching while we're talking about it, aren't you? There's nine of them there, and those are the ones that kind of give you the chills a little bit when you talk about them, right? Okay, so you're going to go with fire. Anybody else here want to go with fire as the worst thing? What's the worst? Thank you, sweetheart. Do what?
Meteors.
That was not one of them. That's more like a dinosaur's nightmare. The grasshoppers is the worst. Grasshoppers. The fire falling. Fire. Fire. Ray, what do you think? Not sure? Well, I've given you those nine, but I want to tell you about the worst one now. The worst one is the 10th one. It was called the Passover. And on that night, they were instructed to take a lamb and to slaughter it. And they took the blood from the lamb that they killed, and they went and they painted it over their doorpost and across the lintel on top and then back down the other doorpost. They took the blood of the lamb and they put it over the doorpost. Okay, remember that. Then they were instructed to take the lamb inside and to cook it. Not to boil it, but to cook it. And they were to cook it and they were to eat some of it. And they were to eat some of the lamb with some bitter herbs that remind them about how terrible it was to be in slavery in Egypt. And then they were to also eat with their sandals on their feet and their loins girded. Now that's a term we don't use much in our, but they had long coats that they wore. And they were told to pull those up, tie them around their waist so they could run fast. They're to eat this lamb while they're ready to go. Because that night, the worst of the 10 plagues is coming. The angel of death is going to come over this all the land of Egypt. In the houses where the blood has been painted over the doorpost, the angel of death will just pass right over. That's why they call it Passover. But on the doors where there is no blood, the firstborn child in that house would die. Firstborn cow, firstborn lamb, firstborn goat. Of all the houses not covered by the blood of the lamb, the firstborn would die. That's the Old Testament story of Passover. Now, in the New Testament, we're told that Jesus is the Lamb of God. And we're told in the New Testament that Jesus was the Lamb of God who sacrificed himself on a cross so that his blood might save us. And they took him and they beat him and they nailed him to the cross and he hung there for hours and then he died. And when they took him down from the cross, they took him and they buried him in a tomb, thinking he was dead.
He made the lame to walk, he made the blind to see, did more than talk the talk, he did. Hey, this Jesus.
Right. They buried Jesus on a Friday. And Saturday was the Sabbath day when everyone was supposed to rest, and so they stayed home on Saturday. And early Sunday morning, before the sun was even up, Mary and Martha, who were very fond of Jesus and loved him, gathered up everything they needed to give him a proper burial. After he had died, they had just hastily put him in the tomb. So they get up on Sunday morning and they walk to the cemetery and they're going to take care of Jesus' body. And when they get there, the stone has been rolled away. And the soldiers who they'd been told were guarding the tomb, they're nowhere to be seen. So they look inside. He's not in there. They look around. Can't find him. The scripture tells us that two dazzling white angels appeared to them in the cemetery and said, "He's not here. He's been raised from the dead." And the women heard that and they left the cemetery and they ran to tell the disciples. Now, I told you there were some soldiers who were supposed to be there. In the Gospel of Matthew, we're told that the soldiers saw the angels, saw the stone being rolled away, and saw that Jesus was raised from the dead. And they went to the chief priest and they said, "We tried to guard the tomb, but these angels came, the stone was rolled away, and he has been raised from the dead." And the chief priest said, We need to gather up an offering for these soldiers. And let's give the money to the soldiers and have them tell everybody that his disciples came, ambushed us, knocked us in the head, knocked us out, rolled the stone away, and they stole Jesus' body, and we don't know where they put him." So you've got Mary and Martha who were there, and they've been told by the angels that Jesus has been raised from the dead. And you've got these soldiers saying, "He's not raised from the dead. They stole his body." Which is the truth?
Is the Son of God. See, confess your faith in Jesus Christ as your Savior. He is alive. He is alive. Come and see that he is risen. He is alive. He is alive. He is alive. All your sins have been forgiven. He is alive. Why are you looking for the living among the dead? He is not here, he has been resurrected. There's only one way to see him alive again. Here it is, here it is. Admit to God that you're a sinner and repent. We believe that Jesus is the Son of God. See, confess your faith in Jesus Christ as your Savior. He is alive, he is alive. Come and see that he is risen, he is alive. He is alive, all your sins have been forgiven, he is alive. He is alive, he is alive. Come and see that he is risen, he is alive. He is alive, he is alive. All your sins have been forgiven, he is alive. Admit to God that you're a sinner and repent. We believe that Jesus is the Son of God. Confess your faith in Jesus Christ as your Savior. He is alive, he is alive. Come and see that he is risen, he is alive. He is alive, he is alive. All your sins have been forgiven, he is alive. He is alive, he is alive. Come and see that he is risen, he is alive. He is alive, he is alive. All your sins have been forgiven, he is alive. All your sins have been forgiven, he is alive. All your
got one more.
I'm going to go back to the night before Jesus died, okay? They're having a supper, and it's called the Last Supper. And while they're having this supper, Jesus tells his disciples, "You're not going to be able to stay with me tomorrow. By tomorrow, you'll all desert me." And Peter's in the room, and he says, "Even if everybody else deserts you, Lord, I'm going to stay with you." And Jesus said, "Are you sure about that?" He said, "I will never leave you." And he said, "I tell you what, by the time the rooster crows in the morning, you'll have deserted me three times." they come and they arrest Jesus in the garden. And Peter follows from a distance. And they take Jesus to the high priest's house where they're going to try him and talk about some of the things that he said. And Peter stands outside trying to hear what's going on the inside. And this girl, this little slave girl, comes up to him. Her job is to wash people's feet when they come in the house. She comes up to Peter and she says, "Haven't I seen you with Jesus?" And he said, "Oh no, I don't know who he is. I've never heard of him before." He moves down the porch a little bit. Another slave girl comes up to him and says, "Aren't you with Jesus?" And he says, "Oh no, not me." He moves away from the house and he goes out and he stands by the fire and he's warming himself with a bunch of other people in the courtyard who are trying to hear what's going on. And one of them in the courtyard says, "I think I've seen you with Jesus." He said, "Oh no, it wasn't me." And somebody else in the group said, "Yes, it was. I can tell by your accent." He said, "Oh, it wasn't me." And while he said that, he heard the rooster crowing in the background. He had denied Jesus. He had deserted him 3 times. We don't know where Peter and the other disciples went while Jesus was on the cross. We know John was there with Jesus' mother, but we don't know where the other 10 were. The morning of the resurrection. The women, Mary and Martha, we talked about a while ago, they ran to tell the disciples what was going on. And Peter ran back to the cemetery with John, and they found that the tomb had been open and that Jesus was alive. And for the next 6 weeks, they spent time on and off with Jesus at various places. He was alive. And then Jesus ascends into heaven. And after he's ascended into heaven, Peter starts to preach. And this time he goes to the temple and he stands on a rock in front of hundreds of people and he says, "I am here to tell you that Jesus has been raised from the dead. I am here to tell you that Jesus is the Messiah." Now think about that. He wouldn't say he was with Jesus in front of the slave girl. He wouldn't say he's with Jesus while he's warming his hands. But now, after the resurrection, Peter will stand up in front of anybody and say, "Jesus is alive." The greatest proof of the resurrection is the change in the disciples' hearts. If they had stolen the body and tried to hide him away and tell everybody he was raised from the dead, they couldn't have stood the heat. But now, no matter what anyone said to them, they could stand strong and say, "Jesus is alive. He is raised from the dead."
Share Jesus. Lord of all creation. We believe He is God, He is King. Let His light shine, let His light shine, let His light shine for you and me. Let His light shine, let His light shine, let His light shine for you and me. We will sing, we will shout, tell the news of His salvation. We will rise, we will shine for the world to see. He is truth, He is life, He is Lord of all creation. We believe He is God, He is King.
Earlier, we sang the song of the ABCs. During the week, we're going to be talking to the children about admitting you're a sinner. It is the call of John the Baptist to admit we're sinners in need of salvation. We're going to ask them to consider believing in Jesus Christ, that He is the Son of God who came, offered Himself as a sacrifice, and has risen again, and to confess that He is Lord. It's the call of Christianity to admit, to believe, and to confess. And this morning, during our time of commitment, we give that invitation to you. If you've never accepted Christ as Savior, do so today. If you're looking for a church home, come join with us. If you have a need in your life you'd like to pray about, I'll be here. But during this time of invitation, may the Spirit work among us. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we ask Your Spirit to speak to us and work in our lives. Lord, in this week of Vacation Bible School, we ask that the Spirit of salvation be brought real and plain and clear into the lives of these children, that they'll recognize who they are and how much they need You. Father, may the stories of Scripture we tell, may these happy songs convey the message of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, raised from the dead to bring salvation to us. Father, I ask that You bless this week and bless now our time of commitment as we deal with Your call to salvation. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Stand, and let's sing.
Destiny. So let us go and let us see the evidence.
instead for him, and he died so that we could live his life. He's the love he gives in Christ, who was crucified. Instead for him, it is finished. Once and for all.
place or not in church to come and to get excited about who God is and to start coming and hopefully bring their parents eventually. But again, it starts tomorrow at 8:30. Registration's at 8:30. You can come in, register in the front, and then we will take your kids until noon. So.
And Robin, we're going to do things a little differently, right? They're going to come into the sanctuary, yes, and you're going to sing for about 15 minutes before we get started. So
yes,
they're not going to be...
They're not going to be waiting outside.
Okay.
But whenever you pick up your children, first through fifth grade will be standing outside on the grass, and kindergarten and preschoolers will be in here. So if you have a kindergartner or a preschool, you'll have to come inside and get them. So it's just a way to keep them safe.
I think your battery's about out in
I
that
think
microphone.
So too.
So, Robin, thank you. We're looking forward to tomorrow. As he said, there's kids all over this town. They'll be here tomorrow, and we look forward to this time of year and this week, and we ask you to pray for us and pray for these children. And if you're not doing anything, there's something for you to do here. You can come down and help us out. It is good to see you in worship today. I would remind our deacons, we'll need to have deacons meeting tonight following evening worship, and then on Wednesday night, our missions and finance committee will be meeting together at 5 o'clock, and you should have got a card on that, but missions and finance at 5 on Wednesday evening. Let's stand for this closing song, and may the Lord bless you and bless us in this coming week.
Y'all want to come on stage? Y'all already know this one. We already did this one. Y'all can come on up and sing if you want. Agency D3, the theme song. Y'all ready? We're ready.
Look around, see the clues, the evidence is clear. God is real, His love is true, the proof is all right here. We're on the case to investigate this awesome mystery. Agency D3, discover, decide, defend. Agency D3. Discover, decide, defend. We're following all the leads with special agent kids. We'll trace it back to just the facts who Jesus really is. We're on the case to investigate this awesome mystery. Agency D3. Discover, decide, defend. 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 We'll always be ready to tell everybody what we know about Jesus. Mission possible, it's not impossible to share the gospel of Jesus. We'll always be ready to tell everybody what we know about Jesus. Mission possible, it's not impossible to share the gospel of Jesus. Agency D3. Discover, decide, defend. 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 Discover, decide, defend. Discover, decide, defend.
Good job. Mm.